So now I'm pregnant with my fourth baby. And there is something very ironic that happened, and I kind of debated about telling you guys about it, but then I realized I had no shame, so here we go. I don't have anal sex. That's just something I don't do. Thank you. Thank you, one lady, who also hasn't fallen prey to that terrible plan. What a fucking terrible plan, by the way. I have a vagina. Why are you asking for that? When did the vagina not become good enough? It was the gold standard for thousands of years. Let's put it back there. It's a CD I'm recording, not video. My paternity pants are falling down. I get all upset. Anyway, so I made the choice, I'm not doing that. And one of the reasons I made the choice for not doing that is I happened to one time see pornography and I saw what the girl's butthole looked like and I thought, I'm never fucking doing that. Whatever happened to her will never happen to me. And so I constantly am pregnant because... I refuse to take it in the back. You all know how anatomy works. I don't have to fucking explain it to you people. You're smart. So I'm in the shower the other day. Don't know, it gets worse. Anyway. I'm in the shower the other day and I'm scrubbing up and I got the loofah because I'm a white lady and white ladies love loofahs. That's just... what we do. I've been to a lot of other ethnicities' houses. I've never seen a black person with a loofah. I've never seen a Mexican person with a loofah. Black people love washcloths. They call them rags. Even if they're like the nicest fucking washcloth. She's like, that's, get a rag. I'm like, that's a washcloth. Anyway, I digress. So I've always had the like predicament in the shower of what do you do when it comes time for hiney washing, because you don't want to use your loofah, because I'm not rich people, I don't have just money to throw away loofahs every time I'm in the shower, and I feel like once they touch that area, they're fucking out of there. So I went old fashioned, and I just rub some soap on my hands, and I get back there and I take care of business. So I'm back there, and I'm cleaning house. That's what I call it, clean a house. And I happen to feel something, and it feels like a bead. Like a little bead. And all I can think in my head is, because I'm a fat girl, all I thought was, I don't remember eating any beads. Like, so I'm having this whole moment where I'm washing, and the washing's getting, like, slower and slower, where I'm like... what sort of foods would make a bead type thing? I'm like, maybe it's a pea gone astray, got lost. But then I'm like, well, it's stuck there, so that couldn't be it. So then I just started to get sad. And then I was like, all right, I'm just gonna wash up and get out. So I wash up, I get out, and then I get the hand mirror out. Yeah, can we all just agree, a hand mirror has never been used for anything except to check your genitals. That's the... that is the reason the hand mirror was invented. That is the only person who's ever looked in the hand mirror is fucking Snow White. The rest of us, Cinderella included, has been like, what the fuck's going on down here? It's always the same questions. You're like, is that a baby or herpes? What is that? You know it's a serious situation when you bring the flashlight into it. I don't care who you are or how beautiful you think you are. The second you see your own anus, You're like, I'm a hideous beast. Oh my God, this is why they invented underpants. Like, I literally saw it and was like, oh my God, I have to buy a lot of doilies to hide it. Like, because everyone knows doilies are classy and they're round. So it all works out perfectly. Anyway, I'm sure all of you can guess at this point, it wasn't a bead. It was a hemorrhoid. I know! I'm so mad! I'm so mad because I worked so long to keep it pristine. And then the baby ruined my ass. Once you look at your butt, though, you know the first thing that goes through your mind? Oh, I get butthole bleaching now. I get it. I get it. Before, I thought that was crazy and gross. But now that I'm peeking at it, I can see it needs work. It needs work. It needs work. I see why God put hair around it to hide it. He was trying to do us a favor, and we just keep taking it away. As you can see, I've been thinking a lot about it lately. Once you see something like that, you can't go back. It's something that sits in your mind and gives you a lot of questions. Here's my final thing. This is my in summation of my own asshole, is that, you know what? It's not supposed to be pretty. It has an ugly job to do. Yeah. It's like a garbage man. You're never like, he's the hottest garbage man ever. They ain't supposed to be hot. They haul trash away. Although it would be nice if my butthole had union benefits. Believe me, with some of the stuff I eat, it deserves it.